the lands between my home. What a beautiful place and what a beautiful day. Such fresh and frigid air. Very cold too. I think I need a new jacket. Ah, it's so peaceful and it's so lovely. I just want to sniff everything. What the fuck is that? Yeah, explosions for sure. A guy coming towards me out of the explosions? And I'm pretty sure that's Doom music playing now. What's going on? Stay away, please.
Shut up, old
man! What do you mean?
No!
Not sure what that was about, but let's just move on from that entire thing, okay? So, anyway, you might look at me and you think to yourself, well, why do I look like this? Well, I look kind of weird, right? Let me tell you, everything looks kind of weird in this world that I inhabit right now, and that is because I am randomized. You might not really fully understand what that means. I guess I'm gonna tell you through a little bit of an anecdote, a little bit of a metaphor, a bit of a story, one might even say. You're like some kind of basement-dwelling, 30-year-old... gamer. And you've been playing Souls games for basically your entire life, okay? You've been playing these for hundreds and thousands of hours, maybe.
Oh my god, bro.
Oh, hell no, man. What the fuck?
I think it's understandable that at some point, you might think that it gets a little bit stale and maybe even uninteresting, maybe even bad. So you've been losing interest in these Souls games. What can you do to get your interest back in these? Well, you're basically looking at it. You're looking at me. Looking at me, and I'm random. So what I'm saying is you should play a randomizer of some sort, right? Because that means that you get to be a floating hair with floating hands and disembodied legs with some weird rune thing as your torso. Obviously, after you randomize the game, weird stuff can happen. Some cool stuff can happen, right? Like that. You also don't have a face. I guess he has an upper face. Funny things, maybe? Like this? He's... Whoa! What kind of first enemy is that? But,
other times... things happen that we don't talk about. We don't talk about those things. He's getting faster.
Basically, using a randomizer means that you get an entirely new game to explore. Okay, the core gameplay might be somewhat similar, we'll get to that soon. So basically, I've discovered the randomizer and I had a thought. A thought that would not let me go, something that I had to pursue. Because it's interesting and kind of funny, I suppose, is what I thought. Sorry. There we go. How fucked up can I make Elden Ring? By randomizing it as much as possible, while still making it, playable. Which is in huge quotation marks, like huge, like even bigger, very big quotation marks, okay? The more random the game is, the higher the replay value, correct? But that's not even all. This is actually two randomizers on top of each other. So the first one that we're gonna be using is the Perim randomizer, which does whatever the fuck you're looking at right now. And the second one is the enemy randomizer, which, well, can't really see anybody, but let me grab somebody. I'll come back in a bit, okay? Just see ya. Wait for me. I'll come back.
A few moments later.
Oh, what the fuck? There's a goat.
Much, much, much later.
I think I got somebody. Hey, it's me. I got someone! Hey! What's up? I got this guy. Very friendly. Oh, what the fuck? What's wrong with you? What the fuck is up with this guy? Please just leave me alone. Let's not get off topic here, okay? The enemy randomizer basically just randomizes the enemies to be different enemies, which are also randomized in some weird way by the Perim randomizer. You see where I'm going with this? I think that was an inadequate explanation, maybe. I don't know. We'll see. We can move on to the good shit. So what I have in mind for the Perims is they are built up in different categories. And that is what I will be doing. I will be categorizing them and then saying whether or not they should stay randomized or they shouldn't. And once that is done, I will layer the enemy randomizer on top of whatever this fuckfest is going to be. After that, I'm just gonna show you what the fuck can happen when you play this, because Jesus Christ, I have like goddamn 10 hours of footage of me playing this fucking randomizer thing. And there are so many moments I made a goddamn document. I had to catalog them all. I had to. There were way too many. Way too fucking many. Now that we've talked about what I'm actually gonna do in this video, let's actually get to, you know, doing it. Basically, my process in this entire thing was just that... Wait, what the fuck is that guy up there? So my process in how I did this was basically I just went through the params that sounded interesting. I wrote them down. I tried out, you know, what do they do? What do they randomize? And then I saw, well, does this work? Is this cool? Is this funny? Or is this just fucking annoying? A large part of them I didn't even try out. Potentially, you can make this way worse than I did. I mean, you're already basically observing the final, you know, result, but trust me, the journey is a fun one. Well, for you, hopefully. For me, it was not very fun. It was quite painful, actually. The very first category, the default params. These are the boring ones, okay? These are just two different game mechanics that get changed, and those are just the loot parameters. It basically means, you know, I kill my boy Jimmy over here, and he would drop something else than he would usually drop, okay? So the first one is random enemy drops. Obviously, that's gonna stay random, because that's usually what, you know, the randomizer does anyway. The other thing is the map items get randomized. That also stays randomized. Pretty quick one, I mean, goddamn, like, what the fuck? These are actually just, like, really normal and maybe even way too normal, so I'm just gonna move on. These are funny random, and they stay on. Default params out of the way, let's move on to an actually very, very important category, which is the equipment. Okay, so first up, obviously, the weapons. The weapon randomization is very interesting because it just kind of fucks everything up. What is the... Whoa! Okay, that's actually badass. Like a different, like, attacks, it's different weapon arts, everything is completely different and it's... It's pretty beautiful. Actually, whoa, that's actually also really strong. What is the spinning wheel? It depends on what you get. Sometimes they remain kind of coherent. Other times they just really don't. So next thing is armor. I think I'm wearing like 17 different sets of armor at once. Okay, the hood is a glove. The robe is actually some pants. The gloves are also pants. And the trousers are actually that... Oh, that makes me go fucking... Oh my god. Fucking want some. But this is an awesome pose. Look at how intimidating I am. And for some reason, putting stuff on actually makes my equip load lower. Which I don't know why. I mean, and the weird thing is, you can't even get naked. Like, let me show you this. This is me unequipping my armor. And I feel like I'm now wearing more armor than I was before. So getting naked with this thing on is definitely not happening. You always wear protection. Oh, I look fucking pretty. God damn. Yeah, I'm gonna keep wearing this. I look sexy. Yeah, we also get to randomize talismans, but that's kind of underwhelming. I never even got footage of a talisman actually working while being randomized. I'm sure that happens at some points, in some ways. It never really happened for me, I never noticed it. Talismans, not really worth it. So another thing you can randomize are the items. But problem with that is it makes them completely fucking unusable. Items are just completely fucked up then. Like, weapons you can still like swing and stuff and sometimes you get like cool attacks. Items you have no fucking idea. Okay. Like, everything gets randomized. So you don't even know which items you can consume. The category does not matter. You can have, like, smithing materials that you can for some reason use. What the fuck? We have that, which I can use. No, can't use that actually. Never mind. Can we use this? We can't because I don't have enough mana. Oh, we can actually summon spirits. So, I'm gonna keep everything randomized except items because that shit is just fucking boring and it makes them completely unusable and it's just not worth it at all. Trust me. There's enough really, really weird and random stuff in this thing that we don't need the items, okay? Which I guess makes the verdict for this category a medium funny random, except for just straight up funny random. And it's all the fault of these goddamn items.
Huh?
Don't be scared. I'm now just an ethereal being, okay? I have ascended to the state of the gods. I have ascended to a higher state of being. I've turned into a nebula, a mist of ethereal energy, okay? So yeah, that's the simple explanation for it. Don't ask me about it, please. Next category, we just had the equipment, so now we're moving on to something that you can actually see right on screen right now, which are the NPCs. Also quite a good one. One that I did really enjoy too, but goddammit, it was also a fucking pain in the ass to actually... Man, me fucking getting hit is actually, it's fucking me up so bad. And I really can't turn it off. I'm pretty sure that I can't even attack anybody. Yeah, I think that I'm actually just like in a different dimension. This one was fucking annoying to figure out because the NPCs really didn't wanna work the way that I wanted them to. They didn't attack me, nothing really attacks me ever, and their attacks don't work, and this kind of stuff is okay, because I think it's still pretty, like, interesting, I guess, that they at least react to my presence somewhat. This was definitely the worst one to figure out how this shit works, by far. And I guess a better name for this thing would be NPC behavior, but, you know, NPCs are NPC behavior, let's just go with NPCs. I think that makes it a lot more recognizable. He's not doing something. Oh, he's doing the jig, oh my god, look at him! I didn't know they could dance. He just did boy at me. Hey, what's going on? Okay, he's doing a lot of stuff. But I can also can- why can't it you? He's stuck. I guess I would call this normal, what am I looking at? What the fuck is this? That's the worst forest I think I've ever been in. I don't want. What's that guy doing? Hey guys. What the fuck? What is that thing? Wait, that's scary. What's that? Yep, everything seems to be in a working order. I think we just watched that guy, like, ascend. What is that? Why is he doing the- what the fuck is that? Why is he so loud? Oh my god, what the fuck? What is- oh, is that? What the fuck? What is up with that guy? Whoa! What is that? What the fuck? I didn't even see. I was so distracted by these souls. Hey. Are you good? Are we okay? I think he's dancing. As I said in the beginning, there will be actual randomized NPCs. Oh, there we go. I thought I just disappeared into the astral plane or something right there, but now I'm back. There's like another setting that just fucks him up completely, like replaces the animations and stuff, and that never really worked. That's really where most of the really goofy shit is coming from, which by all means, like, go ahead and re-enable that if you really think that's hilarious, but goddammit, it was awful for me, because just like 80% of the NPCs don't really do anything. They just kind of stand around in like really weird poses and look at you. which I didn't think was very cool. Yeah, this one definitely stays randomized just for the amount of laughter and fear that this entire thing causes. It's pretty incredible. There's nothing quite like it. We all love a bit of trauma, right? Am I right? Can I get a high five for that one? Huh? So projectiles are separated as either being bullets or being magic. Bullets obviously being stuff like bows and stuff and crossbows and raid bows and all of that sort of thing, and magic being, well, you know, magic. This also randomizes your own, which means that, oh my god, I have ascended even more. That's fucking crazy. Projectile randomization has a really nice and funny side effect, actually, which causes every projectile to basically be one of two things. Either it does fucking nothing. Oh. But I can see him shooting that. Oh my god. Oh. Or it causes just everything in the immediate vicinity to just completely explode and die.
And this should also mean that we can now cast Glintstone Pebble, if that's what you wanna call that. Down here? I'm gonna let loose. What was that? Oh, he didn't do anything either.
But that's exactly what we want, okay? You should be running around with the fear that any small bow attack, that single arrow, could not only crash your game, blue screen your PC, but also completely wipe your hard drive. Yeah, for sure funny random, and for sure staying randomized. I think that's no contest on this one. Next up, special effects. Now, compared to projectiles, which you didn't always notice, special effects will basically follow you everywhere and completely make your life a living hell. Special effects can make you basically broken OP by just doing something like crouching or walking or jumping or, you know, any of that kind of stuff.
I also gotta try out what crouching does.
Okay, crouching is broken. Crouching is good. Oh no, am I now... Oh, wait, I'm kinda... I'm stuck crouching now? What?
Okay. Does rolling into people really just do 800 damage? It most certainly does. But we are going somewhere. What? Is that... I'm poisoned, but I don't really care. I have like 4000 HP. 2000. This works, let's stop. Okay, I can't stop. That's doable. I'm gonna die. Please let me open this.
Oh, we got some rock grease. Let's try that out. Oh, Jesus, what the fuck? Whoa, whoa, whoa. Okay, chill the fuck out. They can also do stuff like insta-kill you by running or sprinting. Okay, I think I just got a tutorial.
Fucking damn it. That scared me too.
For sure my favorite category, not only for ease of use, but also the sheer entertainment value it provides. Yeah, special effects are pretty special. It seems to me like there would just be effects that would be applied on certain actions. Like, you know, walking through lava will make you take damage. Rolling would give you iframes, now they give me like a snow effect, and you know, that kind of stuff just gets shuffled around a lot, which results in probably the most game-changing category in the entire mod. There's going to be some params that are completely game-breaking. Well, this one isn't, well, not always. Sometimes, when you're really lucky, you can even get completely new fucking game mechanics, and this is the stuff that I think is really, really interesting.
Okay, sprinting does,
okay, sprinting actually restores my HP and has an accompanying sound effect and normal effect to it. What the fuck? Like, that's fucking crazy to me. So obviously this doesn't just affect you. This affects every NPC, every surface, I guess. Well, we can do trend. Let me just...
I'm gonna assume that this kind of is not gonna kill me instantly. Yeah, wish me luck. You know, it's pretty fine down here.
I'm gonna come back. Oh shit. God damn it. I don't know where I am. What the fuck? You see that guy? Yeah, sometimes you can just get runes by doing stuff like rolling, and not even a small amount. The void, we can just see the void taking enemies. I can roll and then sprint? Why do I have 1.7 million souls? And rolling gives me 3,000? Rolling gives me like 300,000 souls. What is that? What the fuck? I didn't even see. I was so... Obviously, this is the category with the most content in it, if you wanna say that. And because of the nature of it, you need to be prepared to basically learn a whole new game every time that you hit that randomize button. Like, you need to figure out what the rules are of the currency that you're playing because of this category. Obviously, you know, I can kind of do whatever the hell I want right now because, you know, I'm kind of cheating, you know, I'm pretty much invincible. But if I wasn't, like, there's a good chance that I would have died, like, 300 times doing the shit that I am.
It's pretty fine down here.
But if you aren't using that, you need to be prepared to learn whatever the fuck this thing throws at you. Because if you don't and you just kind of try to play this like a normal Elden Ring, that's not gonna work. You'll definitely have a really bad time. I have, like, a butthole face. That's kind of disgusting, really. It jiggles too, what the fuck? Another pretty important thing about this category is that, sights of grace should be avoided at all costs.
Nice. Oh, what the fuck?
It's fine, everything's fine. Why would...
What is that?
It's gonna happen now. She just disappears. Okay, so I can't even level up or anything. I can't use sights of grace. Wait, jumping? Ooh, jumping is not good. Jumping fucking murders me really hard. And resting at the side of grace doesn't even... Resting at the side of grace doesn't even get me HP back. What's the point of that?
I'm madness instantly. It kinda... Oh. 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 Oh no.
They spit like some snakes out.
That's what America says?
Let's rest. Ah, what the fuck? Okay, we can't rest. Weird stuff happens. And I get... Oh, jeez. I fucking hate this game. I fucking... Why am I doing this? This is fucking stupid. I should never do this. It's gonna be so... Oh my god. Chances of you getting a special effect that will just fucking either like stun you out of the grace or just straight up murder you or murder any NPC around you, including Melina, by the way, which also means that round table hold is also almost off the table. If you can't really rest at a side of grace, you can't really go to round table hold because you can't even talk to Melina. I'm also gonna talk about round table hold more in a- What the fuck? I don't know why he's gotten so close. I'm just gonna assume that he stays down there. I mean, obviously special effects are staying randomized. This definitely gets a funny random from me. And just because of this category, the pure amount of fucking chaos that this causes, you should try this out. There's a download link to the randomizer in the description, and this is me saying to you, please try this out. I also have a list of all the cool seeds that I've encountered. Not all of them, but you know, there's definitely like at least 10-15 in there, which you can try out. A lot of them from this video that you can see right now.